Hi, cat lovers! Welcome to Meow Academy. Today, we're going to deal with a very basic question. Because before you can even dig into anything that's cat behavior, there's just one question we need to ask first. What is even a cat? Now, most of you think you know, but trust me, you don't know as much as you think you do. First thing first, where does cat even come from?
Domestic cat belongs to the feline family. It might be difficult to remember, a little fluffy, cute animal sitting on the sofa actually is the same hunter-killer machine like all these fabulous big cats in the wild. Now, be careful when you're looking at this little guy. They are not your domestic cats. They are wild cats. There are different kinds of wild cats in the world, like European wild cats and African wild cats. When you see these little guys in the nature, don't approach. The feline family has a common ancestor about 10 to 15 million years ago. There are three main categories of cats. You have big cats who roar like lions and tigers, and then you have cheetah in itself in a group, and then you have small cats, and that's where our fluffy domestic cat belongs. The earliest archaeological evidence tells us we start living with cats since 9,200 to 9,500 years ago in Cyprus. We don't know if they are domestic cats or wild cats though. There's one funny thing though, there is no native cats in Cyprus, so someone must have liked cats enough to bring cats to Cyprus. You may now wonder about dogs. Dogs descend from the wolves about 20,000 to 27,000 years ago. The first archaeological evidence of us living with dogs comes from 14,200 years ago, so it's way earlier than cats. So what happened? About 10,000 years ago, we started agriculture, so we started to have food storage. When this food storage, these little friends, the rodents, start to show up, and that attract wild cats to come close to us. And then about 3,700 years ago, they start to slowly move in to live with us. And then things start to get crazy real quick. About 2,900 years ago, we even start worshipping cats. And then guess what? In a way, we have never stopped. And then there is now. There are two theories about what happened. Someone thinks that maybe we forced cats to live with us for rodent controls. But it's unlikely because there are dogs and ferrets who can also do rodent control and it's much easier to handle. And then you have another theory saying that cats probably move in with us by themselves. And we cat people know this theory is much more likely because, as you know, we can't really force cats to do things they don't want to do. So what does this story mean? It means our little fluffy cats sitting on the sofa probably come from Africa. And that affects their behavior. There are many, many traits that we can go back to Africa. One of the things is, for example, they don't like to drink water. And many other things, which I'm going to talk about in the future videos. One extra note, house cats, farm cats, and feral cats, they are not different species. They are all domestic cats who end up living in different environments.
And then take us to another question. Are cats actually really domesticated? The answer is, might not be. There are three reasons. Number one is their body shape and their behavior actually haven't changed very much since they are domesticated. So they might actually not be. They are still pretty much a wild animal. Another thing is, they are very capable to survive by themselves outside. The proof is you can see feral cats, farm cats, or even some cats just live in the nature. And I'm not talking about wild cats, I'm talking about domestic cats who live in the nature. They exist and they survive pretty well. So the bottom line is, they don't need human. And I think most of you know that. And number three is, we don't control breathing. For some other domestic animal, not only we control breathing, Their breeding actually rely on human at this stage. With cats, there is a little bit of breeding now in the past 150 years, but they are breed for the looks, not breed for the use. So you may wonder, what have any of these things have anything to do with me? The answer is everything, because since cats are not that domesticated, or if domesticated at all, their behavior is still pretty much wild animal. In fact, it comes to a surprise that we are living with this tiny wild animal and there hasn't been more accident at home. Obviously, some of their wild behavior has adapted to live with human in modern settings, but still there are many of their behavior have not. And that's why we are dealing with behavioral problems. And very often, these behavioral problems are not really a problem at all. It's just naturally what cats does. It's just that it's not suitable for us human to live with this kind of behavior. And that's where cat behaviors comes in, to help you find a happy medium where it's suitable for the cats and to you. If you are experiencing cat behavioral issues and need help, please check out my website in the description box below. And don't forget to subscribe to this channel. So that's it for today. See you next time. Bye!